YouTube, what's happening? It's Combiner Wars Trailbreaker.
Trailbreaker people mode. Look at me. I am liking this one a lot. I don't know why. That does it for me. That's all it needed is just that. I don't know why. I like the painted wheels. I like all this. It really does harken back to the days of G1. Updated version. He was a pickup back in the day, but he had a hard top, which was part of the vehicle, basically. Just to give you a little Trailbreaker history. And I had him. He was one of my few car G1 originals. I still have him. I still got him. Oh, yeah. He's there. Fists and everything. His fists were detachable back then with the missiles and stuff. I think I might be missing his little radar thing that went on his head, but... Oh, we can pick one of those up secondhand, no problem. But yeah, vehicle mode here. I even like that they painted his grill. That's kind of neat. I think this definitely works for Trailbreaker, and this mode is fantastic. He did come with an axe. Don't know about why, but that's fine. And he came with this thing, of course, the old patented hand-foot deal. Let's look at this guy in his robot form. Here it is. I like it. I like it a lot. Now, I complain a little bit about Wheeljack not having paint apps. This guy doesn't have all of that many paint apps, but he's got them in the right spots. The silver is where it should be. The reds are where it should be. I love the fact that he comes with this missile hand, and there are no other hands to be found. It's just that. I think that's really cool. It's unique to him, definitely. I didn't do a montage here because we have seen this mold, or this guy is a little bit of a remold, obviously, with the hand and the face and everything, but we've seen me transform that thing dozens of times here. He's hard to light because he's so dark and black, and I love that. I think he's excellent. I like his face. They captured that face there, that cubed head that he had with the blue sunglasses type deal, like in the cartoon. His face was a little bit different on the original toy, but that's okay. And I just think this guy wins. He's a winner here. He's the big winner today. Who's the big winner? Trailbreaker is the big winner. He wins. So he can hold his axe with the other hand if you want, or he can hold the hand-foot deal. But yeah, I mean, for the most part, this is cool. He did come with a comic, nothing we haven't seen before, and not showing the comics off that much, so it's nothing special. You're not missing anything. but that's it, man. This guy is, I say grab him. One of the main reasons here is we don't get a lot of Trailbreaker toys. They haven't made very many. The last one I do remember was like a Legion class figure. I think we did get a Deluxe class in the Generations line, but this is akin to that. This is about that scale. So if you're looking for a trail, like an updated version of like a G1 style Trailbreaker, grab this guy, man. He's not the old Trail Cutter. This is the Trailbreaker. Seems like they got that the rights to that name back, and I'm tickled as punch, or tickled as pink, or whatever that expression is. That is going to wrap it up for me, folks. I'm Mitch Santona. Thanks for tuning in to my Transformers channel. This guy's going to become a limb to Skyrain, and that video will be coming up shortly, so stay tuned for that. He will combine with his fellow Autobots to make a big giant combiner, which is going to be cool. We're going to see that alongside some other combiners. So I've got this and much more coming your way. Please subscribe to get the latest stuff. Take care. Thanks for watching. And you guys have yourselves a wonderful day.